أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أرحب بكم إلى هذه الحلقة التالية من سلسلة دراستنا الصرفية. Welcome to the next episode of our lesson series on صرف Arabic morphology. الموضوع the topic اللفيف. لفيف simply means something tied together. لفيف is a kind of verb that comprises of two weak letters. When the two weak letters are close to each other, it is regarded as لفيف المكرون, meaning close لفيف, لفيف المكرون. However, when the two letters are not together, when there is a sound letter in their middle, in that case, the lafif is regarded as lafiful mafruq, meaning remote lafif, because the two letters are not together, they are separate. Now we can categorize lafif into two, as lafiful makrun and lafiful mafruq. When the weak letters, the harf al-illa, when they are together, so we refer to it as lafiful makrun, close lafif. When the two weak letters, the huruf al-illa or the harf al-illa, are separate, we consider it as lafiful mafruq, the remote lafif. Tafa'ala min al-lafif, the nature of fa'un aynun lamun in relation to lafif. أعلم, get to know. أما فعل من اللفيف المقرون, that the nature of فاون عينون لامون that are used to conjugate verbs in Arabic in relation to لفيف المقرون, the close لفيف, يأتي مستقبله مكسورا, the عين الفعل in مضارع usually comes with كسرة. The عين الفعل المضارع usually comes with كسرة. Now, for instance, طوى يتوي. طوى means he has folded, to fold something. يتوي, he is folding. The مصدر is طيا. طوى يتوي طيا. طاوين, متوي, اتوي, لا تتوي. That is لفيف المكرون, because both wa'un and ya'un are close to each other. Then we have shawa. Shawa means to roast something, like yam, meat, shua. Shawa means to roast something. The mudaru is yashwi. He is roasting, or he roasts. So the mazdar is shayyan. Fa'il, shayin. Afwan, shawin. Shawin. So maf'ul, mashwiyun, what has been roasted, mashwiyun. The amru, ishwi, nahayu, la tashwi. Then we cancel the ya, as alamatul jazm. To asluhu, the origin of both tawa and shawa was tawiya. 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 There is what is called al-i'lal in sarfu. There is a principle called al-i'lal from illa illa. Al-i'lal, alifun lamun hamza aynun lamun with alif and lamun, al-i'lal from a'alla yu'illu i'lalan. Al-i'lal, i'lal is the process of weakening a letter. I'lal is the process of weakening a letter. There are three ways by which i'lal can take place. Number one, bil qalbi, by turning a letter entirely to another letter. And number two, bitaskin, by silencing a letter, to silence a letter. Bitaskin, meaning by giving sukun to a letter that was mutaharrik, that was carrying a vowel sound. So taskin, that is the second way. Now the third way is bilhazfi. Bilhazfi, by cancellation of the letter. Bilhazfi, by omit the letter and totally. So in that case, we say ilal has taken place. Ilal has taken place. نعم. Okay, إعلال. Let's take for instance. The word koala was taken from koala. Koala. So the waun has been turned to alifun. That is al-i'lal bil-qalbi. Al-i'lal bil-qalbi. From koala to koala. From waun to alifun. That is number one. The number two. The mudaru of koala is yakulu. It was originally yakulu. Yakulu. The waun in the middle was taken dhamma. So the sukun was later given to waun. Yakulu. Yakulu. So it becomes yakulu. That is taskin. That is al-i'lal bi taskin. Now the third one. The amru of qala yakulu is cool. It was originally cool. Cool. With waun in the middle. Cool. So the yaun was omitted. Because two letters with sukun can never meet in Arabic language. Since the lamun is carrying sukun already. So the waun must be omitted. That is al-i'lal bil-hasfi. Okay, let's now move on. So, asluhu, their origin, is tawya. So, fakuli batul yao. The yaun was turned to alifan. It was turned to alifan. The yaun was turned to alifan. Litaharrukiha. Just because it was taken haraka, وَانْفِتَاهِ مَا قَبْلَهَا, and the letter before it was taken fataha. Whenever harful illa is taken haraka, and the letter before it is taken fataha, so the harful illa must be given sukun. From tawya, from tawa, a tawaya. We are now having tawa. It is tawaya, not tawiya, afwan. Tawaya. Wa yatwi and yatwi. Asluhu, its origin was yatwiyu. Yatwiyu. Whenever harful illa is taken haraka at the edge of a word, that haraka must be turned to sukun, which is known as al-i'lal bitaskin. فَسُكِّنَتِ الْيَاوُ. So the sukun was given to ya. لِنْكِسَارِ مَا قَبْلَهَا. Just because what comes before it is taken kasra. We can still remember the principle. Ya'un goes with kasra. وَمَزْدَرُهُ. And it mazdar. The verb now is ya. Ya'ati ala wazni comes on the pattern. فَعَلَن. Most especially when it is mutaaddi. Transitive verb. Now. طَيَّن. وَالْأَصْلُ. The base. The origin of طَيَّن is Tawiyan, Tawiyan. Kulibatul wawu ya'an. That wawun was turned to ya. It becomes Tawiyan, Tawiyan. So wa'udigimatul yaw al-ula. So the first year was installed. Fil ya'i thaniya in the second year. So it becomes Tawiyan. With shadda, Tawiyan. Wasmu fa'ilihi. The subjective form of Lafiful makrun yati ala wazni fa'ilin comes on the pattern fa'ilun, just like other verbs. Nahaw tawin al aslu, the origin of tawin was tawiyun. We can still remember the principle tawiyun. Whenever harful illa is taking haraka at the edge. So we need to turn the haraka to sukun. فَسُكِّنَتِ الْيَاوُ. So the yaun has been turned to sukun. The sukun has been given to yaun. ثُمَّ حُزِّفَتْ. Okay, the sukun was given to yaun. It now becomes tawin, tawin. Now the waun is taking to double kasra. Double kasra. The yaun is taking sukun. And the nunun, sakina, of the waul munawwana. The waun is taking double kasra, which means there is nun sakina at the end. The nun sakina is taking sukun already, and the yaun is also taking sukun. In Arabic grammar, there is no way two letters with sukun can meet. What do we do? Okay, we now cancel the ya. It becomes tawin. Tawin. La'alla ka fahimta. Thumma huzifat. Then the yaun was omitted. The sukuniha, just because it is taking sukun. And there is another sukun with waun with double kasra. والسكون تنوين and the سكون of the تنوين of the واو بعدها that comes after it واسم مفعوله and the objective form of اللفيف المكرون ياتي على وزنه comes on the pattern مفعول just like other verbs نحو متويجن متويجن والأصل the origin was متويون متويون فكل بيت الواو يان دايان وسطن تويا وسطن تويا so it becomes متويون متويون وأدغمت في الثانية دايان was installed in the second year so it becomes متويون so والأمر and the أمر of لفيف المكرون اتوي اتوي we derive أمر from others طوى يتوي so the أمر is اتوي لا تتوي don't fold فهذفت الياء so the ياء was omitted علامة to serve as a sign للجزم of سكون of سكون that is الإعلال بالحذف we can still remember so والمفروق the لفيف المفروق the remote لفيف يأتي مستقبله مكسورا The أين الفيل مضارو usually comes with كسرة. Now example. وعى. وعى means he comprehended, to understand. وعى, he comprehended. يعي, he is comprehending. وعيان, comprehension. واعين, the one who comprehended. موعيون, what has been comprehended. عي, that is أمر. That is العلال بالحذف. عي, comprehend. The حرف الإلا at the end has been omitted. علامة للجزم to sign as the sign of جزم or إيه we may borrow هاون to make it إيه لا تعي don't comprehend now الشرح the explanation التغييرات the changes التي تدخل الأفعال المعطلة that enter the weak verbs لا تنحصر في كلمتي لا تنحصر في كلمتي can be collected in the term العلال العلال means weakening the act of weakening a letter وهو تغيير حرف العلة حرف العلة it is the process of changing حرف العلة بالقلب by turning it from one بالقلب by turning it from one letter to the other من الألف from ألف to another letter أو الواو from واو to another letter وإلى الياء or from here to another letter. أو بتسكينين. Or إعلال can also take place by giving سكون to a letter with حركة. ما تحرك منها. أو بحذف ما تسكن. أو بحذف. Or to cancel ما تسكن حرف الإلا that was having سكون before. Then we cancel it to serve as علامة الجزم. Just like كل. أن كن وما إلى ذلك. وإذا اجتمعت الواو والياء. When the واو and ياء. وإذا اجتمعت الضمة والكسرة على الواو والياء. وإذا اجتمعت الضمة. When the نمة now come together with كسرة على الواو and وا والياء and ياء. وسبقت أحدهما بالسكون. And the letter before them is taking سكون. كلبت الواو ياء the واو now become to ياء وأدغمت في الثانية and installed in the second letter example this example طويان واو and ياون طويان the واو is taking سكون and the letter before it is taking حركة so طويان we now turn the واو to ياء it becomes طويان from طويان we have طويان which is the مصدر of طوى يتوي so متويون We turn the waun, the second waun, to yaun. It becomes matuoyun. So, we apply it again. It becomes matuijun. Matuijun. Okay, matuoyun, yaun goes with kasra. So, we need to give kasra to the waun before the ya. So, it becomes matuijun with idigam. So, matuijun. We now have matuijun. Wa iza ijtama'at ad-dumma wal kasra ala al-wawi aw al-ya. So, when the dumma and kasra now come on the wa or ya. وثقلت على اللسان meaning when the waun is taking dhamma like yakulu أو الياو or the yaun is taking dhamma like yakidiyu قضى يكدي we now say قضى يكديو وثقلت على اللسان. It will now becomes heavy on the tongue. That is ثقل. سكنت الحركة. The حركة, the vowel sound of the sound letter, the vowel sound of the weak letter will now be turned to sukun. كما the way it is في النحو. يتوي from يتي, okay, يتويو. The original form was يتويو. This is the original form. يتويو. يطويو. يطويو. So whenever حرف الإلا is taking حركة at the edge, according to the principle, their حركة must be turned to سكون. So يتوي will now become يتوي. يدعو. يدعو. This is the original form of يدعو. From دعا يدعو. The original form is يدعو. يدعو. So whenever حرف الإلا is taking حركة at the edge of a word, their haraka must be turned to sukun. That is the principle. So yed'u, yed'u will now become yed'u. So another one is yarmiyu, yarmiyu, yarmiyu. From Roma yarmi, yarmiyu. The original form was yarmiyu. So according to the principle, whenever harf al-illa is taking haraka at the edge of a word, their haraka must be turned to sukun. Following the principle. So yarmiyu will now become yarmi. Okay, here is another one. Yakumu. This is the original form of koma yakumu. Yakumu. So now the wawun is taking dhamma. According to the principle, whenever harf al-illa is taking haraka, so that haraka must be turned to sukun. That is al-i'lal bitaskin. Al-i'lal bitaskin. So yakumu will now becomes the dhamma of the waw will be transferred to kafun. To kafun. So it now becomes yakumu. Waun with sukun. Yakumu will now become yakumu. Okay? Yabiyu. This is the original form of yabiyu. Yabuyiu. Yabuyiu. What do we do? So we transfer the kasra of the ya to bao in order to allow al-i'lal bitaskin to take place. So yabuyiu will now become yabiyu. Yabiyu. Because it will be very heavy on the tongue to be saying yabuyo, yabuyo, yabuyo. For us to be relieved of this difficulty, what do? So we apply al-i'lal bitaskin. So it now become yabiyo. Wahudhifat iza kanat sakinatan fi an-nahw. Wahudhifat. If the harf al-illa is taking sukun at the edge of a word, according to the principle, we are to omit it. Like in tawiyun, tawiyun, it now becomes tawi. That yaun is taking sukun already. So the waun, the nunun at the end of the waun is also taking sukun. So two letters with sukun cannot meet in Arabic grammar. What do? So we omit the yaun. So tawin will now becomes tawin. Here is another one. Ramiyun. This is the original form. Ramiyun is the original form. Ra-mi-yun. It becomes ra-min. Then we cancel the ya. It becomes ra-min as ismul fa'il. Okay, here is another one. Yaw-idu. From wa'ada. Wa'ada means to promise. The mudar is yaw-idu. That is mithal. Yaw-idu. Yaw-idu. According to the principle, whenever harf al-illa is taking sukun, and the letter before it is taking fatha. And what do? We cancel the harf al-illa. Why? Because kasra goes with yaun. Here the ayun is taking kasra. The letter before it is waun. And yaun, kasra and waun do not go together. What do we now do? Okay, we cancel the waun. So yaw-idu will now becomes ya-idu. Ya-idu. Because the waun is now in the middle of yaun and kasra. And kasra does not go with waun. So what do we now do? We cancel the wa to resolve the problem. Okay, yaw-idu will now become ya-idu. Wa iza taharrakat al-waw. And when the waun is taking haraka, is taking vowel sound. Wa yaw and ya. Wa fataha ma qablahuma. and the letter before them is taking fatha. Kulli bat alifan. Their harf al-illa must be turned to alif. Now example. Qawala. The original form of qawala was qawala. Was qawala. Now the harf al-illa is taking haraka. We turn it to alif. We turn it to alif. Bad at skinny. So qawala will now become qawala. That is al-i'lal bil-qalbi. Al-i'lal bil-qalbi. We turn waun to alif. That is al-i'lal bil-qalbi. Here is another one. Gozawa. Gozawa. The harf al-illa at the edge is now taking fataha. So in this case, we are to turn it to alif. So goza will now become goza. Goza means he fought a battle. He fought a battle. That is goza, yegizu, gozwatan, al-gozwa, battle, or war. Okay, romaya. So from romaya, we turn the harf al-illa at the edge to alif. According to the principle, it becomes roma. So nayala. The original form of nayala, which means to achieve something or to acquire, was nayala. Nayala. So well, okay, since the harf al-illa is in the middle, taking the haraka, what do? We turn it to alif in order to allow al-i'lal bil-qalbi to take place. Nayala will now become nala. Tawula. This is the original form of tala. Tawula. Tawula yatulu. It will now become tala yatulu. That is al-i'lal bil-qalbi from wawun to alifun. We turn the harf al-illa from waun to alifun. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Ma'a salama wa ila al-liqa'in akhar.